Auxiliary view is number four. It's a curved top piece, a hole going through it, a block at the bottom. They call it a machine, unmachined bearing block, drawn to the right for you. So it's front elevation and plan looking, and front elevation is looking in this direction. And they're asking for an auxiliary view, which is extra, so it's an extra view, extra elevation, looking from 30 degrees. In fact, they're looking straight onto that surface. Now that surface is that one there. Now that looks like it's circular. We can test that by taking the compasses and trying the height of that, take it up to the plan and check in to see if the width from the centre to the outside, and that is circular. So that's going to be a circular end top with straight lines coming down. And the hole, again, is circular. When you check that distance to that height, it's circular. So it'll be quite easy to draw. Again, I like to label things. I label the plan. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now those are the points that are on the base. And now we need the heights of those. So 1-2-3-4-5-6. So the one in the distance is 2, 1.
Do you want to go again?
No. 6. Just leave it in. 5. Ignore it in detail, so we'll worry about that later. Point 4 is at the back, and point 3 is at the back. We'll mark the heights of that. 2 dashes there, 3 dashes behind us. I've only drawn the base to start with. I think that's the easiest bit. 6 and 6 dash is I'm putting in that point there. And 5 dash and 4 dash at that height. So I'll draw that base first. So 30 degrees. They've drawn the XY line for us, which happens to be this base line here. We're just swinging it round to there. We're looking straight onto that corner. We're looking at that corner. I know these approximate heights are only that, so I don't have to make the lines very long. Three at the back just yet. Using a trammel. So that's the height of all of those, are the same height. So I'll just mark it once and project up at 60 degrees, which is at right angles to the 30. So I see a line from there to there. See a line between 6 to 5 and I see 5 to 4. And it'll go down the back, but that'll be a new idea. Also going to put on is the centre line. As we know they are circular, so if I pick up the centre line, we can find the height of the centre from the front elevation. I'm marking it where the height is on. The height of the circle, because they're circular and we're looking at straight, we don't have to divide the circle up, we can use compasses. Because it's a true circle. So projecting it up, the centre is there, the inner radius is there, the outer radius is there. From the centre to that circle. So a semicircle is there. Extending that up to that line and extending it down to that one. So you can see the curve. And so that's up and over, that's the centre. We'll continue with the centre line for this one. Just finish off with that. And a circle. It's a drawing complete.